putting this sermon together, God told me that this sermon should be preached more than once, because the world is in need of a new heart. Culture controls this world today. I'll repeat, I say culture controls this world today, and for Christianity, this is not good. In other words, we have all kinds of belief walking the streets today. We have all kinds of doctrine. And the United States has become a boiling pot because we have confused God's people. Another threat against Christianity is Islam. Islam is not a peaceful religion. I don't care what your brothers and sisters tell you about it. It teaches hate and preaches hate. And we as Christians must make a stand, and we must do it now. We must come out of the closet, letting the world know that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, which is the only way that we can have a new heart. I said that is the only way we can get a new heart. And if you have a new heart, you have the mind of Christ. And with the mind of Christ, you'll think like Christ. You act like Christ. You'll treat others like Christ will treat them. Of course, we also read that transplanting of a new heart into a body from another is a fact. In fact, Dr. Kristen Bernard led the way, and now others have followed in this type of operation. If this scientific medical miracle does not compare, though, however, to the spiritual miracle of receiving a new heart and a new spirit through the work of the Holy Ghost, which started at the day of Pentecost, when all were baptized, that was the beginning of this new heart. But let us look at six ways that the heart is used in the scripture. Many ways. The first way is used as a physical pump. I was reading the story about David and his followers were running from Saul, and they became hungry. So David knew a fellow named Nabal was rich, had plenty of food, so he sent his followers, a couple of them, to ask them to set up some food so we can eat. Well, Nabal refused to give them the food. In fact, he cut the backside of the pants out so the butt could be seen and sent them back to David. Well, David got upset, and he made up his mind, said, I'm going and destroy Nabal. Well, he had a wife called Abigail who believed and trusted God. So she went and told Nabal what David was going to do. And according to the scripture, 1 Samuel 25, 37, but it came to pass in the morning when the wine was gone out of Nabal, and his wife had told him these things, that his heart died within him, and he became as a stone. The heart controls your thinking, my brothers and sisters. Because Proverbs 14, 30 says, a sound heart is the life of the flesh, but envy is the rottenness of the bone. We need a pure heart, and we need a heart of flesh, because with that stony heart, all you do is follow Satan and not God. And number two, the heart, we refer to the soul affection, the soul's affection, because we read in Psalm 4:7, that I have put gladness in my heart more than in the time that the corn and that wine increased. Well, first, those farmers, when the wine would, the corn would increase, when they get more wine, they had a glad heart. But God said, I'll do more than what they can do then. If someone would come to you and I'd give you $1 million, or your heart would be glad. Be glad for a while. But God can beat that all the way around. He can give you a heart of flesh by saving your soul from a burning hell. And that is lasting joy. That is soul salvation. Many things will make you happy, but they will not last. But God is all in one. Once he gives you a new heart, you have joy the rest of your life. Number three, the heart is the conscience of man. Because 1 Samuel 24:15 said, the Lord therefore be judged and judge between me and thee, and see and plead my cause, and deliver me out of thine hand. We need to pray to God today, because there's so much evil around us. If we're not careful, we'll find ourselves falling into that trap. Yes. But if you pray to God, he will deliver you out of the hand of that devil. Yes. Well, he's trying to take as many to hell as he possibly can. Yes. But I'm so glad. I don't know about you. I found him a long time ago. Yes. And I read in the Word of God, but nothing can separate me from the love of God. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. Yeah, yeah. Then that heart also is a human nature. Because I read in Jeremiah 17:9, the heart is deceitful above all things, and desperately wicked. Who can know it? This world today is ruled by men with hearts of deceitfulness and wickedness. We're in trouble, my brothers and sisters, and God is left out of all of their decisions. That's why we must stand up and let the world know that there is a God. Everything that was created belongs to him. Yes. Oh, I don't know about you, but I'm so glad that God found me when I was lost. Yes. Number five, the heart refers to the mind. Because Romans 10:6 says, but the righteous, when he is of faith, speaketh on their wise, said not in thine heart, who shall they ascend into heaven? That is to bring Christ down from above. So as a man thinketh, I find that so is he. If your heart is not right with God, you have a messed up mind. I'm going to say it again. If your heart is not right with God, you have a messed up mind. And with a messed up mind, you will kill. With a messed up mind, you will steal. With a messed up mind, you will lie. And with a messed up mind, you will gossip. You abuse, you rape. With a messed up mind. The streets today are filled with messed up minds. If you're not praying, it's praying time. Because you don't know who your next door neighbor is, you might have a messed up mind. Some in your own family might have a messed up mind. Yeah, yeah, I'm going to say this more than once. They can live today and kill you today. Messed up mind. Stone their heart. The only one can take our heart and give a heart of flesh is God himself. Number six, the heart is the center of anything and all things. Because I read in Exodus 15:8, and I will what? Make the land desolate, because they have committed a trespass against the Lord. In other words, if you have a stony heart, when your heart is wicked, you will turn your back on God. And he in turn will punish us. You cannot turn your back on God and get away with it. In other words, your heart must be right with God today. Your heart is the center of anything and everything. All of the evil this world is going through now is because of the heart of man. That's why David said, give me a pure heart and a clean hand. Is your heart pure? Is your hand clean? Because if your heart is not pure and your hands are not clean, that's why so much evil in the world today. We have no discern for other people. Everything happening in the world today, we want to take matters into our own hands. Oh, I don't know about you, but I'm in trouble now with these people that truly have been entrusted to, and they molested them rightly. Somebody happened today. Something wrong. But a child can't be a child without somebody messing with them. The mind is all messed up because the heart is not right with God. Well, what have the doctors done? The doctor has only transplanted the heart. They have merely transplanted an organ, a heart pump, from one body to another, which will give life for a while, a short while. But Jesus can and will give you a new heart, which is eternal life.
Yes.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. I know one thing, the heart that the doctors transplant, this organ is no more necessary than the liver or the kidneys or the brain. It takes all that to go together to have a normal liver. God calls us a stony heart. But when he will replace with a heart of flesh, and in fact, it's only one time in the Bible where flesh is used in a positive way. He gave a heart of flesh, which speaks of living. We need a new heart in order to live. Or you might think you're living. You might have have all the money in the bank, but you're not living. Because I found out so many commit suicide. Trying to find out why so many are taking their lives today because they do not have nothing to fall back on. I wish somebody helped me today. I don't care how much you have, how many things you've gone through, but unless God is in your life, your heart is still stormy. And when your heart is messed up, when your heart is messed up, you've messed up all over. I wish somebody helped me today. I don't know about you, because I'm so glad I have a heart of flesh. I don't know about you, but if not for the heart of flesh, where would we be today? So what is a great need in this miracle that the doctor had transplanted? Well, the greater need is the conversion of man's heart by God's Spirit. Amen. God would change it from a proud heart, one that is humble. Because Psalm 101 said, whoso proudly slanders his neighbor, him will I cut off. Amen. You cannot gossip against your neighbor, he's going to cut you off. Lying on your neighbor, he'll cut you off. Talking about your neighbor behind your back, God is going to cut you off. You walk around proud, say, I'm better than everybody else. God is going to cut you off. I don't know about you. When God cuts you off, you have no favor with God. You have no blessing from God. Sometimes you run around and wonder why we have so much hell in our life. Because you might just say something about somebody and did not know what you were talking about. I'm going to read it again. It said that whoso proudly slanders his neighbor, him will I cut off. If you don't want to be cut off, you can't say nothing good about your neighbor. Keep your mouth shut. You also him that hateth and high look and a proud heart. God hates a proud heart. Some of us walk around like peacocks. No sinner, always point your finger at somebody else. Yeah, but every time you point your finger at somebody else, your old thumb is pointed back at you. So be careful how you judge others. You don't know what they're going through that day. Somebody might pass in the church and don't speak to you, not because they don't love you. You don't know what hell they went through before they got here. If your heart is all messed up, it messes up your mind. And when your mind is messed up, you can't be like God himself. That heart, God will change the heart from the wicked heart to the pure heart, though. Because I read in Proverbs 6:14, he said, for water. And that word for water would mean a willful disobedience. In other words, let me put that willful disobedience is in his heart. He devises mischief continually, and he sows discord. This person is no good for nothing. All he do is try to cause disunity. He tried to do everything, not just the house of God, everything in the family, everything in the city, to divide it. Because somehow the devil knows if that word the unity, there is strength. Yes. And gossip and lying and talk about others will divide. I wish I had that one today. You get a measure. I have to keep saying it because the biggest trouble in the church of God today, I'm not talking about my side, the church of God today, we have people come to the house of God with deceitful hearts. Yes. They love to sow discord. They have so much hell in their own life, they want everybody to have hell within them. They can't be, in other words, you married family, be careful because if you're getting along too good, you will have another family that's getting along that wants you to be in the same ship with them. I need somebody to hear me today. We talk about a new heart. A new heart. Hebrews 3:8 said, harden not your heart, as in the provocation in the day of temptation in the wilderness. That's what was wrong with Israel a long time ago. They were told to go into the promised land, but they didn't trust God. God told them, go in to show them. And all they had to send some spies at that. Spies what? God already gave it to them. So they sent 12 out of 10 of them had hard hearts. Come back and we can't take that land. We look like grasshoppers over there. Yeah, but I'm so glad that with two that had new hearts, Joshua and Caleb. They came back because God had given them a blessing. We are the same way today. God will tell them to do something. If we can't see how it's going to be done, but we can't do that. What do you mean you can't do it? If God said do it, do it. I want you to have a happy day. If your heart is right to God, you're not going to fight if it's not right, it won't work anyway. So don't worry about it. Try it. If it's not for God, it's going to fail. Then you can put your, I believe somebody here in the name. We talk about a new heart. What this world needs today. I can understand what God's saying. You preach this message more than one. Because people's heart is not right with God. They might say, I love you, at the same time they hate you. If you got a new heart, you can love. You can love the hell out of them. I don't care what they do to you. Stick in your faith, you're still going to love them. Why? Because God is love. If God is love and love is God, you have to love them when you want to or not. God will change you from double heart to a new heart. Because I read in James 4:8, draw nigh to God, and he will draw nigh to you. Cleanse your hand, ye sinners, and purify your heart, ye double-minded. Nothing worse than a double-minded person. You can't trust them. Because the heart controls your mind, and if a double-minded person, danger. As I said, for he can love you and kill you at the same time. This is the world that we live in today. That's why the Second Chronicles give us the word that say, if my people who are called by my name, humble themselves, you got to humble yourself and pray and seek his faith. But here it is, you got to turn from your wicked ways. Then he said, only then will I hear from heaven, who forgive your sin and will heal the land. This land is sick, but we have the power to heal this sick land. God will give you a new heart. With a new heart, you won't mind praying. I'll go back to you. There are many examples in the spiritual birth that changes the heart of man. Among what you remember, Philip in jail, Paul and Silas were put in jail, chained down. You better hear me today. Paul and Silas didn't complain. They had a prayer meeting at midnight. And she has the prayer and sing, and shackles came loose. Walls of the jail house fell down. Old Philip and Gail jumped around his bed. Yeah, Paul said, don't you run. Don't hurt. But God did not loose us so we can get away. He used us assured that he had power for his children of God. Old Philip and Gail, what must I do to be saved? Paul said, believe on the Lord and Jesus Christ. Not only you be saved, your household will all work be saved. Somebody better hear me today. Another good example was he remembered Paul, when Saul called Paul, on his way to Damascus, persecuted the Christian, kill them all, give them an antidote, kill them. But Jesus met him on the road, knocked him off his horse, blinded him, told him to go to the street called Straight. I did paraphrase it. He went there and a man laid hands on him. Said, call him brother right there and there. Paul opened his eyes to see what it was wrong. Some of us need some hands laid on us. Our eyes need to be open. God is still in the blessing of us. Your heart has to be changed. Your heart has to be changed. I say your heart has to be changed. He changed Paul's heart. He'll change your heart. Paul became one of the great evangelists in the world. But God had to change his heart. I wish somebody hear me. Now that you remember the man in the tomb. A man been walking in tombs all his life. Cutting himself. Chain him up. He break the chain. But when Jesus appeared before him. When look at Jesus. He said, yay. Why are you messing with me? Why are you coming to torment? You've been tormenting all life. Jesus the prophet, I didn't come to torment you. I come to set you free. So that tomb dweller, the one that had been sucking the tomb alive, became a vengeance. Somebody happy this morning. Yeah, but the greatest happened. The greatest happened, he changed the rest such as I. Yeah, I was kind of stony. My heart was stony. A heart of alcohol. Kept me bonded down all my life. Couldn't think right. Couldn't act right. But God one night took that heart of stone and gave me a preacher heart. Hear your crowd. I say, hear your your heart come only about through the work of the Holy Spirit. God seeks and saves those that are lost. And this began by believing what Jesus did on that old word of cross. He set us free from the law. Now we're under grace. Don't let nobody tell you that you have to keep the law. You have no power to keep the law. Just because you can't keep it, you don't keep on breaking it. We are under grace. Grace is a favor you do not deserve. But when God sent his son to die on that cross, and when he nailed the Lord to that old post, all we have to do now is believe that Jesus is the Christ. I'm so glad he died for me. I don't know about you, but it's something about Jesus that will change your thinking. He'll give you the right mind. But the sinner must repent and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Whosoever will, included in God's plan. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. And whosoever, I'm so glad that whosoever was me one day, whosoever me shall not perish. son walked in with a starting heart. For the prison of the word, your heart had been made flesh. Come, give me a hand. And give your heart to God. And now we're here this morning. Does it join the doors of the church are now open? All I have to do is come.
Thank you.